Hello YouTube, Dutch Bushcraft here. I'm gonna talk to you today about going to a country for some bushcraft and survival by plane. Because if you go by car, yeah, you can put basically anything in the trunk. But if you go by plane, you also know that everything you bring there, they will see. So you have to take care of the laws of the land. Maybe there's a lot of corruption, etc. So I went to Colombia to do some survival and bushcraft, and what I brought was my trusty old Swiss Army knife, just for the everyday carry in the city. I did bring my last resort items: the pocket knife, fire steel whistle, tick remover, and the scraper. I did not bring the fat wood. Some countries are very particular on bringing in wooden products. So I left this one at home. Then I brought the pink Zwart peasant. Pink because it doesn't look offensive at all. They will probably laugh. I like to carry it in my made by myself leather pouch around my neck when I'm in the field, when I'm in the city, maybe doing some picnicking. I really liked these mochilas, or bolsas as they call them in Colombia. You can find them everywhere. Very convenient for carrying some extra stuff. Very comfortable to carry. So yeah, that's a big plus. I actually, if you go on this side, later had one made out of strong denim. And I'm still using this one as of today. Everyday carry, and also for the bushcraft, for small trips, or just a hike in the woods. Okay, back to the knives. I brought a Hultaforce as a backup knife, but also for the missus. I left this one in Colombia. This one is a workman's knife, so it's also not offensive at all. I normally always test the knives I bring, except for this one, because this one was sent to me for review by Brisa, a Finnish company. You can find them at www.brisa.fi. It's an Enzo Elver in 12C27 Zandvik steel, Scandi grind, G10 handle scales, and what I like most about it is the already prepared lanyard hole and the rivets in the silvery color. It comes with a nice thick leather sheet, and because I was going to test this in Colombia, I did nothing to it. I just put it in the suitcase and then took it out in the field over there. You can see the full review on that in another video. I didn't bring a machete, even though I was going into the jungle, because I figured there will be a lot of machetes on sale there, and there are. They are just not the best quality. I bought a different one than this, even cheaper than this one, and used it, and it performed well, just not the quality I am used to. I left it there with the missus, of course. This one I brought back as a souvenir. So this one is not used at all. So if you are traveling by plane, you have to remember that there's rules of the land you're going to. There's customs. They might be corrupt, you don't know. So it's better, at least that's my advice, and I would sure not bring my most expensive, exclusive knife. Because if they just say, okay, this one is not allowed, even though you know, because you googled it, that it is allowed, what are you going to do? They won't leave you into the country, and you will lose your knife. So I like to bring the non-offensive stuff. Now I visited Colombia. All was fine at customs. I did see no corruption at all. So next time, I'm more confident to bring a more expensive knife. or even a few more knives to review in the jungle, because it's a different environment than the woodlands we are used to here. More about that in the review of the Enzo Elver. Okay, that's it for now. You all take care. Travel safe.